So, if you look at the Mehrotra committee, the idea of better salaries, working conditions, and clearly defined recruitment criteria were considered to be important to make overall improvement in the teaching learning process. The Mehrotra committee, in this context, proposed to introduce a national test to recruit teachers in the higher education institutions, UGC 1986. UGC introduced national eligibility test examination from 1989 onwards, which is continuing even till today. Teacher recruitment and training. The teacher plays an important role in ensuring quality of education imparted. It is often said that the quality of an education system cannot exceed the quality of its teachers. Henard and Rengit 2008 talk about this. And then Harvey and Stensaker 2007 talk about how all institutions of higher education strive to develop a quality culture which is strongly rooted in teaching and research. Scholarship of teaching is different from the scholarship of research, according to Boyer in 1990. The good and extraordinary teachers know what to teach, how to teach, and how to improve. So we have Stephenson 2001, which talks about that. And in a paper by Varghese, myself, and Gautam 2017, some of these qualities required in effective teaching reflect an individual passion to the field, while others can be developed through proper identification, recruitment, and training of prospective teachers. That it's no one is born a teacher. You can ingrain these qualities and imbibe these qualities as you go along through proper recruitment, identification, and training. Factors influencing teaching and learning. The students from disadvantaged groups form the majority in many classrooms in India today, as I had just mentioned earlier. Many of them are first-generation higher education learners graduated from schools following the regional languages as medium of instruction. And Sabarwal and Manish 2016 from our center, CPRHE, have done a study on looking at how institutions should sensitize themselves to these diverse populations and recognize that we need more diversity in terms of the teaching and in terms of the teacher recruitment in order to cope with this diversity in the student population. The traditional classroom practices and teaching learning process may be less effective in addressing issues relating to student diversity in the classrooms. The other factor influencing teaching and learning is technology. The new generation students are net generation learners, that is, internet generation learners, and are more comfortable with relying more on the digital technology to plan their studies. They depend more on online learning resources than on the traditional library resources, printed books, and on teacher as the major sources of information and knowledge. So today, when a teacher enters the classroom, the teacher has to be far better prepared in terms of answering questions and become more interactive, because we are not having the traditional lecture mode anymore. Teacher recruitment patterns. Teacher quality is linked to recruitment, as institutions want to recruit and retain teachers who are well prepared, effective, and can make a difference. The issue of supply of teachers is not so much about the numbers, but about the quality. Adequate number of teachers and low pupil teacher ratios are a necessary but not a sufficient condition. Equally important is that teachers are motivated and supported. So we need to motivate teachers, we need to support teachers, we need to provide them all the benefits in terms of all the housing, the medical and other benefits, so that they feel secure, and also keep them motivated. It's very important to motivate and encourage teachers so that they recognize that they are in a very important profession and that they are responsible for the future of the next generation. Teacher recruitment procedures vary among countries. In some countries, teachers are part of the civil service, and other institutions are granted autonomy to recruit teachers. International patterns of teacher recruitment. In the United Kingdom and USA, institutions enjoy the autonomy to recruit university teachers. In the United Kingdom, higher education institutions have primary responsibility for the recruitment, retention, and development of their own staff. Each higher education institution is responsible for deciding on the number of academic staff and for determining the qualifications and criteria involved in each case. The Czech Republic, Netherlands, and Slovenia also follow university-based recruitment of academic staff in the universities. Universities are free to determine the number of available positions for academic staff in Denmark, but the maximum limit for the number of professors is determined by the Ministry of Finance. So you can see that there is a lot of variation across countries, even when there are similarities in terms of the international patterns of teacher recruitment. The German academic career is not tenure track. By law, a junior staff member cannot be promoted to a professor within the same institution. However, one becomes a civil servant from academic assistant onwards. This means that compared to other countries, academics in Germany obtain tenure at a relatively late age, as on average one becomes academic assistant at the age of 42. Due to the university system that guarantees the university relative academic freedom, the position of professor in Germany is stronger and more independent than, for instance, in France. Teacher recruitment in India. There are two types of teacher recruitment in India: institution specific recruitment or recruited as part of the civil service. Teacher recruitment in most of the universities, that is the central and the state universities, are to the institutions. But in the colleges, we have recruitment to the civil service. They are governed by the rules, regulations, and salary and service conditions of the university and are not part of the civil service. In this case, the university notifies the positions, constitutes a selection committee, and invites candidates for interviews. The typical process of selection in nearly all the central state and state universities in this country takes a long time. Teacher recruitment in India. Learning depends most of all on the knowledge and skills of teachers. Teachers have a critical role to play in the development of an inclusive and effective education system. Their recruitment becomes all the more important in order to hire the best and the brightest. This is more crucial in the current scenario where there are more attractive career options, which I had just mentioned earlier, to choose apart from teaching. However, like I said, that the 7th pay commission and the salary hikes have enhanced the profile of teaching positions. So we have the committees and commissions on teachers, starting with the Radhakrishnan Commission 1949. Radhakrishnan Commission talked a lot about the academic freedom of teachers, talked a lot about the autonomy of institutions, and emphasized that unless you allow teachers to have their own voice, you cannot have an effective education system. The Education Commission, that is the Kothari Commission 1964, the Sen Committee 1974, National Policy on Education 1986, the Mehrotra Committee, on whose recommendations the NET exam was introduced 1983, National Commission on Teachers in Higher Education 1985, the CAPE Committee on Autonomy 2005, Yashpal Committee 2009, followed by the Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching, PMMMT, focusing on teacher development and research to improve the quality of higher education in 2015, and finally, the National Policy on Education, the draft National Policy on Education 2019. So, if you look at the status of faculty positions in central universities, we see that there is the universities which became central universities before 2009, and then after 2009, there is a lot of variation in terms of the vacant positions. But in general, there are a large number of vacant positions in central universities. This is something that we are grappling with. It's a very, very serious problem that we have a large number of vacant positions in central universities. And this source is N. Sabharwal, 2015, in the University News, which talked about the role of central universities and equity and excellence. So, if you look at the level wise teaching staff in university teaching departments, we have the assistant professors and then the full professors, the associate professors, and the full professors. And we see that the number of vacancies are most at the level of full professors. So, we have a real crisis of leadership. We have a crisis in terms of having senior professors who are leaders, and we have a large pool of assistant professors. So, in a sense, it is becoming a pyramid, and so that is another crisis that we are dealing with, that we have a large number of assistant professors and few associate and full professors. That also has implications for promotion, and why that has implications for promotion and affected by promotion, because we have a large number of assistant professors who have not been promoted to associate, and large number of and associate professors who have not been promoted to full professors. So that is another under caste. So that is another problem that is we have to confront. So we have it both in the universities and, as this slide shows, in at the college level.